Welcome to ePaathshala lecture series for the post-graduation courses. We are discussing on cryptography network security. Today we are going to discuss about advanced encryption standard. The objectives are to understand AES selection process, to know the details of Reindahl, the AES cipher, and discuss about the steps in each round and the key and key expansion to understand the implementation aspects. So when we are using a DES algorithm where they use only 64 bit key. At the time of 1970 when this algorithm were used, that time there is no issue related with the security. But later on in the year 1996, they able to understand that the key size which is used for encryption processes very, very small. So, but also the DES has various version like a double DES and triple DES, but they are considered as slow and small blocks. So US NAST issued a call for cipher in 1977. In that particular conference, 15 candidates were accepted in June 1998, and 5 were shortlisted in August 1999. So their aim is to have the same as that of your DES algorithm to overcome the drawback with the key size. In AES competition, they specified the requirement in that they use the private key symmetric block cipher, that means a secret key which is used in the case of your DES algorithm, that is comes under your symmetric key cryptography. Again, this AES is an symmetric key algorithm, symmetric key cryptographic category, and they mentioned about 128 bit data and also 128, 192, 256 bit keys. And also it should be stronger and faster than triple DES, where this should have a very good security strength. And also it should be high computation when compared to the triple DES. So it provide full specification and design details, and also it will be implemented both with Java and C programming. So initial criteria were used for AES evaluation is security, cost, and algorithm implementation characteristics. Finally, they use this criteria, general security and ease of software and hardware implementation, implementation attacks, flexibility, that means encryption, decryption, keying, and other factor they consider to make the final list. So AES shortlist, where after testing and evaluation, the shortlist in August 1999 were 5 algorithms. One is MARS, RC6, Reindahl, Serpent, Twofish were being selected for the final round. And among this 5, the Reindahl, which is clean, fast, and good security margin, is become the AES standard. So found the contrast between the algorithm with a few complex round versus many simple rounds, refined version of existing ciphertext versus a new proposal. So this Reindahl, where it is an AES cipher, the Reindahl was selected as AES in October 2000, was designed by Vincent Reinman and Johan Damon, Belgium, issued a FIPS pub 197 standard in November 2000, an iterative rather than feastal structure. AES is DES's feastal structure, where we discussed each and every time one part of our block is not going to be encrypted, whereas here it is an iterative, it is not non-feastal structure. AES is a non-feastal structure that use the processing of block of 4 column of 4 byte, that is 128 bit is going to be considered as a block of 4 column, and operates on entire data block in every round. So AES becomes simplicity, has 128, 192, 256 bit keys, and it is taking a 128 bit data for each and every block of operation. It is high resistant against the known attacks, speed and code compactness on the CPU. That means even nowadays various internet related applications for the security, they are using the AES algorithm for and providing the confidentiality. So now we are going to discuss about the working of this algorithm. The conceptual scheme where we can able to see as the plain text, the size is going to be 128 bit and the key is going to be 128, 192 and 256 as we mentioned for this key size, where it is going to be given to the block called AES, from that it is going to generate the ciphertext. This is the conceptual schema. Similar to that of your DES algorithm, we have rounds and the rounds are almost identical. There will be smaller change in first and the last rounds, that is last round is somewhat different from the other rounds, whereas all the other rounds is going to be same. How the rounds, as in the case of your DES algorithm where we are taking 16 round as a fixed, but in this case the rounds are purely depends upon the size of the key which is given this particular table. Now if you are considering a key size, suppose I am taking 128 bit key, number of round is 10. So if I am taking 192, the number of round is 12. If I am taking 256, the number of round is 14. So what we can able to understand here is, depends upon the key, that is the key, suppose Alice want to share with Bob, if he is choosing 128 bit key, then this encryption process involve only 10 rounds. Suppose Alice is sending 256 bit key, where they are going to deciding on the key size is going to be 256 bit, then the number of round is becomes 14 for the encryption. So this is what the number of round, it is purely depends upon the size of the key which is going to be used. In this case where you can able to understand here, suppose I am taking 128 bit key round, then each and every round I will be generating a new key, that is what the process we call here as in key expansion. This process is called key expansion. If I am taking the cipher key, for example either 122 or 192 or 256, all these are going to be expanded and I will be generating the round key for each and every round. As this process, it look like similar to that of your previous mechanism DES, where only thing is it is going to be increasing the size 128 bit key as well as ciphertext of various key size. But round internally it is going to have a different structure of your DES algorithm, though it may have the similar number of rounds or it is going to be having the rounds during the encryption process, internal operations are going to be different. That is what we are going to discuss about. So the high level description about this encryption algorithm is key expansion. We know very well round keys are derived from the cipher key using the Reindl key schedule, and initial round where we add round key, that means each bytes of the state that we call as a state, we say that column, that is where we mentioned in the case of your Reindl algorithm, where we consider 4 column of 4 bytes, 4 column of 4 bytes is called state. As what we can able to see that it is going to, each byte of the state is combined with a round key using bitwise XOR, that is initial round. And rounds, each round, that means suppose if I am taking 10 rounds, each round except the final round, we can able to see that there will be different stages. For example, one substitution, another one is okay, then we have a shift row, a mixed column and a round key which will be added. That means we can able to understand in the round process where we can able to see that there will be a substitution byte is a non-linear, shift row is a transposition step and mixed column is a mixing operation, mixing of each column, mixed column, shift row, substitution byte, that is non-linear substitution. Substitution byte is a non-linear substitution, shift row is transposition steps, where in the mixed column is mixing operation of each column, and final round will have only, there is no mixed column. So what we understood here is, this is what my overview of working of the particular algorithm. Initially every key is going to be taken is before starting of the encryption process between Alice and Bob are the users who are going to participate in the communication. Later, the key is sent to the key expansion module. This key expansion will take care of deriving the cipher key for each and every round, that is a round key. Then this round key is going to be initial round and final round. Apart from the initial and final round, there will be n number of rounds that depends upon the size of the key. The initial round will take the add round key, then the round is going to have these operations, add round key, apart from that we have a substitution byte, shift row, mix column, and finally we are going to have the last round, that is the final round, it is having the substitution byte, shift row, add round key, except the mix column. So now I think we can able to understand how the encryption process is going to be happening inside your AES algorithm. So we have to keep in the mind that we should have these operations inside each round, substitution byte, shift row, add round key, mix column. That way we are going to understand. And now we are going to see the overall structure of AES algorithm. Okay, so here we can able to see that this block is explaining about encryption process. The other side of the block is explaining about, that is your right hand side is getting about your decryption process. So in the encryption step, where we can able to see that there is a key expansion model, that is your input key. For example, I am taking 128 bit key. This 128 bit key is expanded, not like your previous algorithm, where it is each and every time it is going to be expanded and it will be added to the plain text which they want to send between the users. So the plain text where it is taking the input to the add round key, where this word 0 to word 3, that means word it is going to be having a group of words 0 to, that is 4 words, this 4 words is equal to 128 bit key that will be added to the plain text. And after that we have a substitution byte, shift row, mix column and add round key. During each and every operation, the last each and every round, during each and every round, the last is going to be an add round key and first is going to be a substitution byte, shift row, add round key. So now if you assume that user want to send a message, that message is going to be break into smaller blocks, that is the size of 128 bit block. Then this 128 bit block is going to be added with a round key as the initial round. And later on this block shows a one single round. This is the first round, second round, third round, like that it is going to be a 9th round and the 10th round. So we can able to observe here on the 10th round there is no mix column, that black color block, there is no mix column. That means all the rounds have 1, 2, 3, 4 operation, whereas the last round will have 1, 2, 3 operation. And this is going to be converting your plain text into a cipher text. Now our cipher text is ready at the user end, then it is finally transmitted to the receiver end. If I assume that Bob is receiving this particular message or the cipher text, now the entire process is going to be inverse, that is called a decryption process. We can able to see that it is going to be inverse of the process. So now we can able to see that add round key here on the decryption process during the last key expansion, it is add round key, okay, that process you can able to see that. And then every block inside the round where it is inverse of the encryption process, we can able to see that here is a inverse shift row, inverse substitution byte, add round key, and it will have a inverse mix column. Now one point we can able to observe the difference between your encryption and decryption operation here is the last round is going to be the input where the last key, that is your W 43 to 40, okay, that is going to be used, 43 is going to be used as a round key to the cipher text. And inside the round 1 we can able to observe there will be a inverse shift row and inverse sub bytes. And you can able to observe here there is a swap between your mix column round and add round key in the case of your decryption, where I have add round key before the mix column round. That is the only change with respect to your round in the case of your decryption. Similar process is going to be happening for the round 1 to 9, but in the last round we can able to observe that there is no mix column. So now this entire structure is explaining about the AES operation of encryption and decryption, and also it is mentioning about how a user send a message, and also similarly how a receiver, suppose a sender is sending, how this process is going to be encrypted, and if the receiver is receiving the particular message, how it is going to be decrypted. So we have to understand that there will be n number of rounds depends upon the key size what both are agreeing before sending the particular message. And changes with respect to the encryption decryption processes, the entire encryption is going to be inverse in the case of your decryption. The thing here is, when the taking of key from 40 to 43, it is using add round key, and later on the round is going to be happening till the last round, but the change here is the mix column is happening after the round key, which is there in the case of your before the add round key in the case of your encryption process. And final round, 10th round, always we can able to see that there is no, the last round, that is 10th round, there is no mixed column process. So now I think we can able to understand the entire working of this algorithm. We are going to discuss one by one what are the process involved during the encryption. So here we are taking 128 bit value, that is your user message. As already we have mentioned, the data block is used as 4 by 4 table of bytes. So now we have 4 by 4 matrix of 8 bit bytes. That means it is going to have each and every value is going to be 1 byte, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that it is going to be having, okay, that bit value in each and every block. The key is expanded to array of 32 bit word, key is going to be expanded with a 32 bit word. So now we can able to understand this is our block which is going to be used for encryption, as it is considered as a user message. The process is explained in the case of your block, this block. For our understanding, it is mentioned here what is a byte and what is a word. Word is having 4 bytes, that means each word is 32 bit. That means 8 into 4, 1, 2, B is 8, 8 bit, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 into 8, 32. So each word is 32 bit of size. Each word is, okay, sorry, each word is going to be 32 bit of size. So now we can able to understand how the blocks are going to be converted into a state. Okay, so here we can able to see that 1, 2, 3, 4. That is B1, B2, B3, B4, that is each is going to be 8 bit, so 32 bit, 32 bit, 32 bit, 32 bit. These 32 bits are going to be converted into a, we call that a state. This is a user input, how the data are going to be converted into a state. Okay, here is a how we are going to insert operation. Okay, so we have to think of this SI mod of 4. That is I divided by 4 of block. That means it is going to be S is I mod of 4. That means I am going to take 4 block, 0, B0, B1, B1, B2, like that. B0, B1, B2, B3, then B4, B5, B6, B7, like that I am going to arrange the data in the state. So this process is explained with this particular diagram where it is mentioning as a flow from top to bottom, and again top to bottom, again top to bottom, again top to bottom. So that it is going to be a 4 column value. We mentioned earlier it is going to be considered data block as the 4 column value. This 4 column value represent one state. So an example is given how it is going to be mapping. So text, if you are taking this AES, SUSE is matrix, that way it is, that set is mentioning their corresponding hexadecimal value is taken, and this is going to be mentioned as the block state. This is the process of changing the plain text to the state. Once the state is generated, now it is entering into the round. As we know earlier, the round is going to be consisted of substitution byte, only substitution operation is going to be happening. Shift row, only shift up, shifting the row from left to right, that is going to be happening, and mix column where we are going to add with some predefined matrix. And finally, the round key which we are getting from the expansion block is going to be taken. This process is going to be converting the state from one to another, like that each and every block is giving a new state, and finally we are arriving one state that will be given to the next round. So this process is continuing until we get the cipher text of the encryption process. So substitution byte, what is substitution byte? Sub byte, a simple substitution of each bytes. So as we know, the basic operation behind any encryption errors, modern cryptography, is confusion and diffusion. Now the simple substitution of each byte will provide a confusion. So it uses one S box of 16 cross 6 byte containing permutation of all 256 8 bit values. So I think this is the structure where S box, this S box is going to be considering all the information which I want to map as did in the case of your DES algorithm, substitution S box. One S box of 16 cross 16 byte containing the permutation of all 256 8 bit values which are there in the case of your state. Each byte of the state is replaced by byte indexed by the row and the column. That means we are taking a particular byte 95, then this 95 is splitted into 2, that is 9 and 5, where 9 is the row value and 5 is the column value, so which has a value of 2a. Now this 95 is going to be substituted by 2a. So the same process, if I am taking 95 here, 9 is taking it to the row, 5 is taking the column, and the corresponding position, what is the value is there going to be replaced by 95, that is what the 2a we had in the case of this particular example. The S box consisted using the defined transformation values in the Galois field of G of 2 power 8, Galois field of 2 power 8. So this diagram is explaining about the substitution block design used in the case of your encryption. The other side of your, this part is explaining about the decryption. So here 16 independent byte by byte transformation, we will take first, second, third, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth. Like that each and every byte is going to be taken, and the corresponding X and Y position is going to be noted, and they are going to be interpreted into a new value with the help of your lookup pointer. So this is a S box which is used for substitution. For example, we already taken 9 and the 5. Let me see that what is the value in case of your 9 and 5. It need to take 9th row and 5th column, the value is 2a. That is what we got as an answer. It is a simple lookup process where we will take each and every byte and we will split into 2 half, and based on this we will get to the row and the column value, and this is going to be substituted. That is why it is called substitution byte. The inverse substitution, again the same process. For example, 2a, I want to know what is the 2a value. 2 is the row value and a is the column value, and we can able to see that the inverse value is 95. We get back the original value. So this is happening during the decryption process of your AES operation. So here how this is going to be converted into this value, for example 00, 00 where it is going to be converted, and 1, 2 how it is going to be converted, every time it is going to be converted, the state is changed to a new state, and also it is inverse of each other. So we have considered the AES selection process, the detailed of Eindahl, the AES cipher, look at the step in each round, and also we discuss about the key expansion related with that. Thank you.